Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to continue our FL Studio series where we use only FL Studio plugins to create pro-level tracks. So we're going to model this track for Travis Scott. I'm so hyped because I just found out about a plugin that I overlooked for however many years. Let's hit the plus sign. Let's go to SAR by ImageLine. This models a Moog synth, and you can't get enough Moog in hip-hop and popular music. I mean, this thing is ubiquitous, meaning it's in a lot of tracks. I even heard it in a rock track recently, the Moog sound. So I didn't know this was this versatile for whatever reason. So I bought the full edition. Let's go to the presets. Let's go to default. Click on default. So I'm going to show you how to use this thing from the ground up. If you're new, just follow along. And no worries, again, you're going to get these project files for free. So don't worry if you get lost along the way. So instead of using a preset, which you could just pick a preset, I would suggest going to your base presets and then starting there. The great thing about this plugin, in short, is that it has a mono function, which is one note only, and it has poly, which means you can play multiple notes. And that opens up a whole new world for the Moog sound. So I'm hyped they have the poly in here. So in short, okay. Firstly, we're going to set our polyphony to the max, which is 24. Your system may or may not be able to handle that much, but that's just so we can play a lot of notes at once, especially when we start stacking voices. Next, we have to determine what are we going to do with this. So let's use this SAR to create like a pluck sound. So let's pull it up 12 semitones under transpose, pull it up 12 semitones. So in the higher octaves. Now we're going to go to what this is called an ADSR. You don't have to memorize this stuff. Just follow along. We're going to pull down what's called the sustain and then pull down the decay a little bit. So it has a natural decay or death to the sound. And let's pull up the release a bit. So it has a nice little tail as if we're playing a guitar. You kind of hear it. The sound just doesn't stop right away. It kind of has a longer tail. All right, and let's see. So now we have the core of the sound. Let's create a melody, and then we're going to build around the sound. Again, you're going to get these project files for free. So if you get lost, it's fine. We're not going to get too crazy with it. But this is also not necessarily a beginner's video. This is just how to use FL Studio plugins only. Let's turn our tempo up to about 150. I've noticed that the higher tempos in trap tend to have a little more, you know, oomph behind it. I don't know what it is. It's just, it feels different. So let's right click, go to piano roll, and let's draw out a melody. So you want to think creepiness. So we're going to use a lot of half steps. So, you know, in short, let's go to half step under snap to grid, the snap to grid functions. What we can do later on is slow the melody down. So I suggest starting at a higher octave. That way, when we add a plugin called Gross Beat, it will go to the lower octave and sound decent. So I'm going to start with the high octave. Now let's see what it sounds like if we overlap. So that's our half step note. That's going to give it that trap sound and a horror sound. Actually made that was an accident, but it sounds cool. Then I want to go dum bum 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 bum. Always go by your mind. Bum 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 bum. Okay, your brain is smarter than what your computer is doing. Now I think I picked the wrong notes. That's because I didn't listen to myself. Bing, 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 bing. Boom, 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 boom. There we go. And we're just going to repeat that. Now, longer melodies. The reason I'm using this kind of shorter melody is because we want to be repetitive. That's kind of the trap feels, to be repetitive. Let's go back to SAR and let's start kind of chiseling out the sound. Actually, this kind of, it has too much tension. It makes us want to feel like, okay, we have to resolve it. So let's do that with the melody. Now this one, I'm going to take out that bottom note. And then we're going to, let's hit Control-Z a couple times. Control-Alt-Z, just to go back. And we're going to highlight this, hit Shift, left click, pull it over so it duplicates the same thing. What I'm going to do is delete the bottom note. So that will be our resolution sound. And that will kind of wrap it up and then restart it. I think that's a nice way instead of adding more notes. Okay, now let's go back to SAR. Again, this is not necessarily a beginner's video, but if you get lost along the way, it's fine. You're going to get the project files with the link below. So let's start with, we're in a higher octave, so plus 12 semitones. The first thing I want to do is add more tone. So let's go to the sub-saw. Think of this as an oscillator number 2. Let's just turn up the level, which is the volume. Now it's the same note, so what we want to do to make it sound different is pull the octave down to negative 1. So now it sounds like two different notes. I'm doing this so we can hear it. Now here's where the magic comes in. Let's use the unison voices and pull it. Let's first detune the second voice. Let's also go to the unison voice, pull it up, and then detune it. And then widen it out with the unison panning. I want to hear it an octave lower. Let's just pull it down back to normal. Now let's do what Moogs are famous for, filtering. Let's add a low pass filter. It's set to a low pass by default. Let's add some resonance here. I want to add some key tracking for the filtering just to kind of change it up a bit and add a lower cutoff. I think that should be fine. Let's try a different octave. I'm gonna pull it back to where it was. Now another option is you can go half octaves, which sound really good, but we're just gonna use the octave. Okay. Let's add that to the playlist. Let's go to the playlist and just left click, drag pattern 1. Loving FL12.5. I can't wait till we get to the colors so I can make it really colorful. That really is inspiring. It's all about staying inspired. So let's create the chords. Let's add another SAR patch. And now this one, I don't think we need the full polyphony. It doesn't really matter because this is a max amount. But just, you know, if your CPU goes crazy, that's just want to lower your voices. Let's go to SAR number 2. And remember, you can always convert this to audio if it gets too crazy by right-clicking. And then render as an audio clip. You can do that. Let's go to SAR number 2. Let's go back to the presets, go to default. And this one, I just want to make a bass line. So let's start with, okay, where are we at here? Let's pull it down, all the way down, negative 24. Now here's the fun part. Let's add monophonic mode, which means only one note at a time. I like that ring it has, the high frequency ring. Let's give it some attitude. Let's add a unison voice. And that's the Moog sound. Now since it's mono, meaning the unison panning, not the voicing, it has like a phasey sound to it. Let's add a low pass filter. Let's add some resonance. Now, the more resonance you add, the more Drake-ish it's going to sound. Okay, so let's see what we have so far. I'm going to add another oscillator, sub-saw, and pull it up an octave. You can barely tell, so let's do 2 octaves. Oh, you know what? The cutoff. Didn't that sound cool? So I like this higher octave. Now it's going to sound Kanye-ish. That sounded really cool. So let's... So... We're going to do octaves. I'm going to show you the notes in a second. Let's just record that little patch there. We're going to D, grace note to A, then D again, and an octave lower. should have let the metronome go so I could record that again. I'm just going to record it again. Let's turn the metronome on so we can keep recording. Because I had a nice longer riff. And let's do D, high octave, grace note to A, and down to D. I hit the wrong note at a certain point, which is fine. We can always go back. So this is the MIDI. I'm going to make it more Mike Dean-ish with some... I would layer, but CPU is already pretty high for two sounds. I hear I'm going to lower the velocity. It doesn't need to be that loud. Now here I meant to hit A, but I hit the wrong note. Whoops. And I think we were doing A to, we're doing G to A. That's what I meant to play. I'm gonna edit the MIDI. All right, let's work on the sound a bit. Now I wanna keep it mono, because I think that gives it the attitude, that phasey sound. Crank the level a bit. Now I want to keep this velocity the same all the way through. So what I'm going to do is just crank it all the way up. It's just easier for me to do it that way, and then turn the volume down here instead of trying to make it a lower velocity. I think that's pretty good. I don't think we want to do anything else to the sound. Let's pull it up a bit. I'm gonna add a little more filtering. All right, so that's that sound. Actually, the filter kind of had the most attitude. I know that was a pretty long patch for two sounds, but you know, this is how we get into that vibe. Now let's add some effects to the first sound. First, let's add Fruity Delay 3. Let's put it on ping pong mode, full pan width, and let's do a high pass filter response. Lower your cutoff and raise your resonance. Pull down your wet level. So our goal with this is to make the sound nice and big. Let's add on track 100, let's do Fruity Reverb 2. Fruity Reverb 2. Pull your wet level to 100%. And let's, okay, there we go. Pull your dry level down. I'm gonna increase the width. And then you can set whatever you want here. I'm just gonna take out the bass. Cut out the bass here as well. Let the highs come through. And now I'm gonna click on track one and left click and send that sound to the reverb. I think this sound could use a little more grit. I'm going to pull the sub octave down an octave. It's going to add that distorted sound. There we go. Now let's just experiment. Let's see what gross beat sounds like. That gross beat, let's click on presets, go to momentary, and let's do half speed just to hear what it would sound like if we were to slow down. Sounds cool as an intro. It's actually very emotional sounding. I'm actually surprised. For some reason, this pulls my emotions a lot more than the original. But what I'm going to do is trying to blend the two. So let's pull the moment. Let's pull the mix level for gross beat down in the mixer to halfway so it blends both the sounds. so we have both. It's almost like a second melody. What is a second melody? I think that's a really cool sound. Let's add an EQ to the bass, boost up the lows a lot more. Let me just do a reference check just to make sure I add too much bass. This is just a reference plugin. This doesn't come with FL Studio. I'm doing this so I can hear what it sounds like. Yeah, that's a good bass spot. Those are the two main sounds. Let's find some drums. Actually, let's add another kind of bell sound. So I found some bell sounds in Ogun. I didn't get the full version yet, so we're going to skip Ogun. And let's go to Harmore. Let's find some bell sounds. Let's go to Presets. And actually, I didn't want to go to Harmore. I wanted to go to some retro. So ImageLine was just way ahead of their time. Like they created plugins a long time ago that are now the sound of modern music. So they were way ahead of the curve. So in the plugin, where is it at? It's called Fruity DX10. This models the older synths, like the DX7 and the, I think they made a DX10. I'm not sure of all the models, but regardless, if you click here, you're going to have presets from that older sound, that retro sound using FM synth. These type of sounds. Now, these are actually relevant in modern music. So let's see. Let's find something that matches this vibe. Now, there's also a plugin called, where is it at? As the song plays, I'm looking for it. I might just be thinking about this plugin. I think I'm just tripping myself out. I thought I was thinking of another plugin, but I'm pretty sure this is it. So let's go here. Actually, no, it's tripping me out. I always forget the name. It's not drum synth, but it's the other synth other than the DX10. Forgive me for taking up so much time on this small thing, but let me find it. Oh, SimSynth, that's what it's called. Alright, forgive me, it took a while to find it. So SimSynth also has these retro sounds. I found a nice brass patch in here. Nice 80s sound. So you know. So those retro sounds that are actually, you know, coming back, we can access those now. That's the plugin I was looking for. SimSynth. So let's look for a patch we can squeeze in here. We're not looking for any bass. We already have a bass. So, you know, sounds like the Oberheim sounds. Let's try some bells. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. So I'm going to boom, 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 boom. So again, this is almost like a third melody, but it's not really. They're more like accents. Doom, boom, boom, boom. I like that. It's very horror sound. No, wait, I'm hearing like a... Now it's getting chaotic. So instead of having the two melodies go at the same time, what I'm going to do is right-click, create an automation clip, and turn it on for the intro and then off for the second half, which means the melody is going to go back to normal after this automation is off. So let's right click, tell it to go off. So at 100% it's on, at 0% it's off. And let's take out the bells until the... You can even have like a nice intro for your bass. Maybe do something different. Rowdy, rowdy, late night, you know, those type of things. Now I want some nice chords to go. Let's see what we can do here. Let's add that bell to the reverb. Give the reverb a longer tail. There we go. That's nice and creepy. If you want more distortion, you can always add distortion using Fruity Wave Shaper. Or let's do Fruity Fast Distort on the bass. If you really want to drive it, give the extra whatever, you know. Something's up with the melody, hold on. Trying to decide if I want orchestral sounds or grand piano. That's my decision now. Yeah, I think it'd be... Let's go to packs, let's go to instruments, let's go to orchestral, and let's go to string sections. Let's right click, open that up. And new channel. Now this is Direct Wave, the new player. So this, you know, looks way cooler and it's not small. And it's a really cool string section. These are like the sounds that go unnoticed. Let's add a nice string patch underneath the track. It's like... something like that. Now let's do lower octaves. I want to pull the velocity down for this because it's velocity sensitive. Okay, let's figure out the chord. Now, it's probably going to be A minor. Let's just hold the AC. Pull that down. There's a lot going on, so it's getting too busy. So you want to tuck the strings. Instead of like moving the strings around, because it seems like we're adding another element, let's just hold the chord A minor. That way it's steady and we don't have to like get distracted by it. I think these bells work better for the slowed down melody. So let's actually reverse that. Let me give you a preview of what the melody I have in my head is. Let's open up the plugin called Pitcher. I just realized my mic was on the filter the whole time. Here's what I should be sounding like, but whatever. Too late now. Let's add the high pass filter. And let's add a plugin called Pitcher. Now this one, we want to map out the scale. I think we're using all the white notes here. I don't think we use any flats in this, I don't think. Let's see, D, G, A, D. Yeah, I think we're going all white notes, so go to pitcher. Now, I have a deep voice, so I'll have to set my minimum lower than you. I didn't mean to make it sound like that. Let's go to minimum 25 hertz and just take out the sharps. And now I'm going to lock into the scale. And let's give it a format. Let's see what I sound. Let's see. Ready, ready. Ready, 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 late night.
Roddy, Roddy, yeah. Roddy, it's lit. Roddy, Roddy, late nights. Working late nights, yeah. Roddy, Roddy, late nights. I'm working late nights, yeah. Slave ship on the graveyard, on the grave ship, I'm working.
Alright, so here you get it. We're gonna do the vocals later. I just wanted to give you an idea of where we can take it.
Roddy, Roddy, Lena.
Okay. So let's add some drums. I sound way different with the mic off the thing. I apologize. You didn't hear my real voice. Let's go to pecs. Let's go to drums first before we go to drums by mode audio. So one thing. Boom. That's what I want the rhythm to do. So let's find a nice kick that kind of just sits well in the mix. Actually, let's start with the hi-hat, because I have that in my head. Let's right-click, open that up. I want this to be a little bit different, so let's go to pitch range 12 and pull it down a notch. I want it to be lower pitched hi-hats. Let's add this in. Let's start over here. So, boom, brrta. So let's drag this out. And let's go to the pattern mode. Boom, brr, boom, brrta. Boom. Okay, let's right click, go to piano roll. So, boom, brrta. So I want it to go brr right here. Let's drag that out halfway through. Again, change your snap to grid to half step. And let's hit control U. Okay, let's see what it sounds like. There we go. Nice and creepy. That's a little early to my ear, meaning it sounds like too early. So let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift. I want it to kind of sit in the groove a little bit more. There we go. Okay, let's find the kick. I'm trying to use the sounds in the program so you don't have to download anything. Like this one, it has a nice texture to it. Might need a little more bass, but let's, before we get into all that stuff, let's add our kick in. Let's find a snare. This is the one I want for the tone, but we're gonna do a lot to it. Mainly, let's go to track 8. We just gotta brighten it up. Let's add an EQ. Use the high shelf. Whoa, that's where we want it, but we just gotta turn it down. There we go. Actually, I want it to clip, but I don't want to clip the track. So I think we can, let's do Fruity Limiter. That might be compressing it. I wish there was a way to just clip it without. Forget how to do it. We might have to record it. I just like it. Let's just record it clipped and see if we can do something to it. Let's go to Edison. Let's record on input. And let's just drag this into the channel rack somewhere. And let's trim out the silence. Now it's clipped, but I don't think we're clipping digitally. I'm not sure. I could be wrong. How to clip without clipping. We're gonna have to investigate that. Let's add that in. But that's the sound we want. That's the perfect sound. It's kind of weird to be clipping, but I'm upset it's clipping. Hmm. maybe a limiter. I don't want to, you know, obsess over this, but we have the sound. It's just, how do we not make the whole track clip? So I want to add a limiter. It's probably going to mess up. It to compress. Whatever, you know, we'll figure that out later, but it sounds really good clip. I know we're clipping the track. Let's give the snare a little more bass. Actually, it doesn't have that bass frequency I was hoping it had. Let's see what we can do with that kick. All right, the hi-hats need a little more work. It's a little too slow, so let's go tick, 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 tick. So I want to go Yeah, let's switch it to snap the grid. 1/3 beat, add triplets in here. Now it's too repetitive, let's clone that, make it into pattern 6. So we're gonna go pattern 6, then pattern 5, just to change it up a little bit. I know we're not making like small changes to make this a full record, because that'll take up too much time, but let's... We just want a small little roll, and then we're going to have the full roll on pattern 5. Turn the hi-hats down. Let's see what some distortion would do. The snare. There we go. Now it's loud without clipping. There we go. All right, now we just need the bass to cut through a little bit more. Add that vocal in. When we get the vocals, I'm gonna work, you know, process that better. But let's, all right, so let's see what else we need. We have hi-hats, we have bass. I think we have everything. Now for the bells, I'm gonna add Fruity Delay 3. And then I want them to have a pitch bending response. So what we need to do is use modulation. Let's slow the rate down. It kind of changes the pitch. Well, not kind of, it does. adds like a shimmery sound. So if I turn up the rate, you can really hear it. But we want the rate to not be so audible. On that kick. I want to change up the kick a bit. I'm going to go boom, boom. Clone that. Oh, too fast. I'm going to make these patterns unique so we can do small little change-ups. It's a quick way to create clones. The kick could be a little more. Let's see what Fruity Fast Distort can do. There we go. Add a little reverb to the snare so it doesn't sound so dry. Just left click. I want to add another saw in here just to add like a cool solo sound. So let's see what we can do. Let's go to default. This time, let's start it back over. Sorry. Let's go to mono mode. So we're acting like it's a regular Moog. Let's add a sub level and let's do a fifth, which is a half octave. Actually, it's not going to sound good. I don't think. Two voice unison. Just gonna kind of improv, see how this fits in. If it doesn't fit in, it doesn't matter. I don't like the fifth, so let's do one octave. Widen out the bands. What else is gonna make this a square so it cuts through a little bit better? I wanna add a third oscillator. It's a little more complex. We're gonna add oscillator 3. Turn up speed. I think this is strictly basically an LFO. Let me turn this music off so you can hear me. Let's see what we can do with frequency modulation. don't think we need another synth. I think we just need vocals. So let's add these vocals and then wrap this one up. So we're gonna record raw vocals and then add these effects. So let's take these effects off the recording chain. So you're gonna hear me like this. You're not gonna hear all these special effects, not just yet. I want to come up with a hook idea, I'm trying to think. Something like that. I don't like that boom boom. Let's fix that kick pattern. It's gonna throw me out. I've been up. Here's the songwriting test. Can you write vocals to it? That's how you know if it's a track or not.
I've been up.
Something like that. But I need a longer hook. I guess I'll mumble my way through it, but I would like to give you better. But let's just record the vocals. I'm going to put on a loop record just in case I come up with something at the end and want to go back again. So let's just enable that. Let's record audio into playlist as an audio clip.
You might. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on ya. Lately I've been up, yeah. Sleep is late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Day and every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. When she find me, she behind me. Can I even know a diary? Plus she lied to me, I don't even have a bribe. We just vibing on the way I'm riding. Am I riding? We still rolling the leaves, but no, no weed. But we just wanna get the cheese. Know what I mean? We on that double dose of lean. Hop inside, we just riding in the beam. You catch a beam if you rise up. We don't wanna wait late nights on the ship. No. We don't wanna wait these late nights on the ship. We don't wanna wait these late nights. We don't wanna wait these late nights. Every day and every night, we should ride. We don't wanna wait no late nights. We don't wanna wait no late nights, yeah. We don't wanna wait no late nights, yeah.
Kinda rough sketching it, but you know, that's just what it is. I'm gonna quickly add some effects. We'll wrap this one up. Let's find the vocal. Firstly, we need to unmute it because we were on loop record, so it mutes it. Let's go to the mute tool, unmute it. Let's send the vocal, where are we at here? We have two, let's get rid of this. Send it to track 9. Let's just kind of start with pitcher. And again, take out those sharps. My voice is low, so it's gonna minimum 25 hertz. And let's turn the retune speed all the way down, all the way up, whatever you wanna consider that.
You might, yeah.
Is that a format?
I've been up, yeah.
Gonna add Fruity Flanger. Pull the mix level back. Let me restart it so the melody growth speed is right. Is that an EQ? So it added a small delay due to Pitcher's processing power. So let's just slice out a bit. Let's go to Snap the Grid None. Slice out the beginning and just hit highlight the vocal. I'm going to tell you this is moved vocal, just so you know. And let's hit shift left. 1, 2, 3, 4.
You my, yeah. You my, yeah.
So it hits on beat.
Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah.
Let's go back to EQ.
They say you my, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah.
It's gonna roll the flanger down and let's add a fruity compressor. That's a reverb. Pretty delay 3.
When she finds me, you might, yeah, you might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah, you might, yeah, you might, yeah.
Let's compress it a little bit more.
I've been up, yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on ya, I've been on ya. Lately I've been on ya, I've been on ya. Sleepless late nights, yeah, I've been on ya. Day and every night, yeah, I've been on ya. When she find me, she behind me. Can I even know her diary? Plus she lied me, I don't even have a bribe. We just vibing on the way.
I'm lowering the retune speed so it doesn't pull on every single note.
You might, yeah, you might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah, you might, yeah, you might, yeah. I've been up, yeah.
I might whiten out the bass. Yeah. Let's go to the bass. Pull out the unison panning.
You might,
that kind of takes away.
You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
Let's get the levels right.
I've been up. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Day and every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. When she find me, she behind me. Can I even know her diary? Plus she lied me out.
Alright, so when I move stuff around, it messes up the momentary effect. The half speed effect. So I have to make sure I'm not doing anything to move stuff around. So also I want to make sure this.
You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah.
I don't know how that happened, but somehow I moved that over.
You might,
let's also look for more percussion.
You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
Add more energy to it by adding more percussion. So I know this sounds weird. We're going to add that in. And I'm going to show you how to make it creepier. We're going to go to the pitch tab. Pull it down. Well, firstly, we need to make sure it's tuned to the key. We're doing this by just listening. So it's just ding, ding. Okay. Now let's go to the envelope and let's right click on a different C. So it's in a lower.
We just vibing on the way I'm in. Riding in my ride and we still rolling up. Please, but no, no weed. But we just wanna get the cheese. Know what I mean? We on that double dose of lean. Hop inside, we just riding in the beam. You catch a beam.
There's a lot more to Travis Scott vocals than just that. We can't do everything in one video.
You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah.
I'm just grabbing random sounds that I like.
They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
I don't know why it keeps playing the melody out of place. Probably because I keep moving stuff around.
You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
Like what just happened. Just then. So I might record that melody because it's kind of driving me insane.
You might, yeah.
That's what
you
I would do to
might,
get around.
Yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
Just finding random tones again.
I've been up. Yeah. I've been up, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what happens at this point. So let's record the audio because I have no idea what's happening at a certain point. Let's record into Edison. Where are we at? Edison. Record on input. And I'm going to mute everything except the effect. And I'm going to only record the one section. So let's go to Edison. Record on input. Hit stop twice. Hit play. That sounded cool. Boom, boom. At the end. Let's send that to playlist and let's use that instead. That way we don't have the plugin rereading the audio and different things. We can get rid of the gross beat effect automation. You don't have to worry about all this. I know I might be talking over here, but listen this audio to track 13 to unlock everything. And let's pull it back up top. Now we just have to edit it to make sure everything's good. Let's go to snap the grid none. Zoom on in. There's a little silence in the beginning. You want to hit shift. And I shift right click to get rid of the silence to the left and just pull the audio back to the left. Now we're going to grab the slice tool, snap to grid bar, hit shift right click, get rid of the excess to the right, and then you can control B to paste it. As long as you were doing the steps I just said. And it looks like I forgot our melody went back to normal. So we have to insert pattern. What was that? Pattern one? Yeah.
My, yeah, you might, yeah. Oh, I've been up.
So now we don't have to worry about
oh, I've been up, yeah.
The effect on track one. We can actually
they
get rid of
say
it.
You might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah.
Sounds a bit.
Hop inside, we just ride in the beam. You catch a beam. If you rise up, we don't wanna wait.
since I kind of the song kind of disappeared at that point, let's just duplicate the beginning. So I'm focusing on the section where we have the change up, which is right here. I just added that percussion in. Boom, 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 boom. So we're doing that kind of, it's a style that Drake took. It's like a percussive, use drum machine loops. Adds a little more motion to the track. And I'm just finding random sounds again. But it sounds really cool. Now we're adding like a musical collage. So it's like boom, boom, boom. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might. You even might want to filter out the bass at this point. So let's get a little exotic. At this point, let's raise the resonance of the bass. Let's go to SAR 2. Let's right click, create an automation clip for the resonance. Right click, copy, and right click, paste, or hit P. This is gonna hollow out the bass a little bit more. When you have the resonance up higher. Also, let's lower the filter so it's, whoops. Let's do that as well. Let's insert another track. Let's go to SAR 2, right click on cutoff filter, create automation clip. This is another great thing about ImageAlign plugins. You could just right click and automate whatever you want. So let's right click, paste, and just lower the cutoff. What this is doing is muffling the sound further. I just like adding my own touch to it so it's not so run in the mill. We can do panning and all that later. I don't want to get too microscopic with this video. Where are we at? Pattern. What is this here? Pattern. What pattern is this? Pattern 13. What's on pattern 13? The bongo. You might, yeah. Let's do another thing with the SAR too. Let's right click and create an automation clip for the unison panning. What this means is we can make it a stereo image, a wide stereo image at this specific point. So we get that Drake stop. You might, yeah. And that way it leaves room for the other stuff. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. This needs to be a little louder. So let's right click, channel volume, create automation clip. Right click to copy those values so it's easy to get back to where you were. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. This way we can take the song into a different direction. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up. I kind of like that vibe. So let's keep it slowed down with the melody. I think that's what we need. So I'm going to add little stuff like this in the background. This is stuff that people just overlook. FL Studio comes with a lot of good stuff. Just gotta know where it is. So I'm gonna add this in the background. Now this one, I'm gonna make sure we EQ it just to get rid of the low end so there's no clashing. Let's add a high pass filter. Okay, so it's good to go. Let's add that on the downbeat and just add that on the, you know, wherever we switch it to a new section. You might, yeah. Let's add a lot of reverb to it. That's a really cool sound effect too. These are really cool effects. They work perfect for the sound too. You might, yeah. I'm gonna add this on our snare layer. I'm gonna clone it, however, so this is a build-up sound. And let's add it, where we at? What was that? Pattern 12. Let's add that to the where pattern 12 should be. Let's pull this stuff over so we're still keeping that vibe going. And hit shift, left click, pull it over. You might, yeah, you might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. Let's pan those on. Say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. What I'm going to do is add fruity, where is that at? Fruity Panamatic. And let's go to triangular shape. I want to pan this out, so let's pull the amount up. You might, yeah. You might. Turn it to pan. You might, yeah. I'm trying to make it pan so we can hear it. You might, yeah. That way it keeps moving instead of staying still. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah. I might do vocal ideas in the background just to give you that real idea. See, our snare is now making its clip with all those claps. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. I love this turnaround. Let's start from the beginning. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up, yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Oh, before, I'm gonna restart it, sorry. But let's click on the patterns, let's hit shift. Highlight them all. Here's where the fun comes in. Let's right click, go to rename and color, and let's give it a gradient. So Travis Scott, his vibe is like, dark. So let's do a dark violet to like a darker violet. Let's click the plus sign. I'm gonna pull up this tab and let's click on something dark. Okay, hit enter. Now it gives us a vibe kind of look. You might, yeah. I'm gonna move the automation just so it's not killing the vibe. Let's pull it down. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah.
You my I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleep is late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah.
What I'm going to do is brighten that section up. I know we're clipping, but it just sounds good. It really sounds good. So let's go to pattern 4. And I'm going to copy the strings, but I'm going to put it into a SAR patch. So let's add another SAR. And let's go to default. And I want this to be a nice big unison. Now, this may crank up the CPU and make it cranky. We don't know yet. But I want to make it a really harsh tone. So it adds to the energy of that buildup. Let's hit Control V to paste. Let's add it in over here. And let's work on the sound. Now let's see if we can even identify it. You can kind of hear it. That's kind of whatever-ish. let's detune the sound. And where are we at? Pull up the polyphony. Pull up the panning, I meant to say. And still kind of low. Let me see what it sounds like. Pull it up one octave, plus 12 semitones. Let's give it a little release tail, little attack. And let's, okay. I'm gonna work with the tuning here. I just want to make it a really bright tone, very, so it cuts through. Don't be afraid to add white noise. Now it's a matter of just getting the right tuning. So I want to go. I want to add like a melody in here that's you don't recognize it. You don't even hear it, it's just very subtle. That an EQ, and let's brighten it up. The high shelf. I want to make the sound harsh but not overtake everything. So I'm going to look into harshness. Maybe adding. I think. Pull everything down a bit so it's not flipping the track. I've been And I forgot to change out the bass. Actually, no, I think that's what we want. Never mind. Forget what I just said. Let's start from the beginning. We did a lot in this track.
You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Dead every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Dating every night, yeah. I've been up,
yeah. Alright, let's mix this and then might, yeah. Let's wrap it up.
You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up.
Is that a limiter to the bass?
Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
Give it a quick attack.
I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah.
Add a compressor to the melody. I'm actually gonna do Fruity Limiter because it's visual, and it's the same thing as a compressor.
You might,
except
yeah.
The ratios are different. Let's go to compressor
you
mode.
Might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah.
So I know we're getting a little advanced. You can learn more in our Mixing Academy at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy.
You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah.
We're gonna add that to the main.
Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Dating every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, yeah.
Now for the bongo sound, let's make it a little more digital. Usually I would do, let me see if Fruity Wave Shaper, let's see what the presets look like. I think they, yeah, a bit much. Here we go. Now let's turn the mix level down. I would usually use Fruity Squeeze, but sometimes it the volume goes crazy. So let's.
You might.
Just a little bit of that.
Oh, I've been up. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up.
Alright, let's go back to the beginning.
You might, yeah. You my, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you my, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. I've been up. I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah.
I meant to send the slow down to the reverb.
You my, yeah. You my, yeah.
There we go.
Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you my, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Hey, I've been on, yeah.
Is that Fruity Panamatic?
I've been up, yeah.
To the hi-hat.
Sleep is late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Staying every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you my, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. I've been up.
I added the triangle to the reverb.
Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up.
I think we're good. Let's move to the master track. I'm not gonna go crazy with all the explanations here. Let's right click, go to 20 hertz, 18 kilohertz cut. Just pull up the 18 kilohertz cut frequency to 20 kilohertz.
You my, yeah. You my, yeah.
You hear the bass come through a little bit more clearly doing that. Let's add another EQ.
You my.
I have to use my reference because I don't hear as much bass as you hear.
You my, yeah. You my, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up.
Making sure I don't boost the bass too much.
They say you my, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah.
I'm gonna really just be very broad with the master here.
You my, yeah. You my, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah.
What's that a fruity?
You my, yeah. You my.
Limiter, but in compressor mode.
You my, yeah.
An experiment with my, yeah. Compression on the whole track.
Lately, I've been up, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Yeah, I've been on, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Day and every night, yeah. I've been on, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up,
so it's not really a limiter, it's a compressor.
They say you my, yeah. You my, yeah. You my, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah.
I want to add Maximus, but I've noticed that Maximus tends to add a color to the sound. Like, if you listen to me, it does something to the sound. So I usually use this for stereo separation. They don't have a plugin specifically for each band of stereo separation. You can make one in Patcher, but it's, you know, I mean, I guess we could try and do it now. Let's see. How would that work? Well, never mind. It would take too much time.
Lately, I've been on, yeah. I've been on, yeah.
What you would have to do, though, just so you know, go to Patcher. And you'd have to split the bands using, I forget the plugin. You'd have to use the VFX, where is that? VFX, keyboard splitter. Or you can, I think you would use just EQs, bars, pretty parametric EQ too. You would split up the bands. So you would need a mid-side. This is, it's way more complicated than it needs to be. But you'd split up the bands, then you'd split each thing into a mid-side, and then do it that way. But that's just way too complicated. So let's just disregard that.
Lately I've been on ya. Lately I've been on ya.
Is that a limiter?
Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah.
It's gonna get significantly louder, so I'm gonna turn off my mic.
Lately I've been on ya. Lately I've been on ya. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on ya. Lately I've been on ya. Lately I've been on ya. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Day and every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Day and every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been on, yeah. Lately I've been on, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Sleepless late nights, yeah. I've been up, yeah. Day and every night, yeah. I've been up, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. Oh, I've been up. Oh, I've been up, yeah. They say you might, yeah. You might, yeah. You might, yeah. I've been up. Yeah, I've been up, yeah. Lately I've been up, yeah.
So there you have it. If you want these project files for free, go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. I'll leave the link in the video description so you don't have to search everywhere for it. Just click the link below the video to get these project files for free. That way, if you missed any steps going along, you can always have the blueprint. It was fun making this track. We're going to make some more videos using FL Studio plugins only. So thank you for watching here. It's busyworksbeats.com.